So question number 21. Yeah, this is today's question. A factory produces 84,000 units. Okay, during the year. So ye per annum hai. This is yearly. Okay, yeah. So this is what my units produced and units sold. Units produced. Sales at what price? Selling price is 50 rupees per unit. Cost structure of the product is given. The cost structure is what? Is as follows. Raw material, labor, overheads. Sir, percentage diya hai. 55, 18, 17. Okay? So obviously, it is on this price. Okay? 50 rupees ka 55%, 50 rupees ka 18%, 50 rupees ka 17%, like that. Okay? Samaj mein aaya? Is this clear? Acknowledge it in the chat box. Samaj mein aaya? Next. Activities of purchasing, producing and selling occur evenly throughout the year. Okay, fine. Okay. Next. Raw material equivalent to 1.5 months supply. Okay. So raw material is what? My current asset. Production process, that is WIP, takes how much? 15 days. Finished goods, kitna bola hai? 1 month production. Okay. Debtors, 1 month credit. Creditors, 2 months credit. Time lag means outstanding. Payment of wages and overheads is 1 month. Oh God, aage kya bola hai? Cash and bank balance to be maintained at 15% of the working capital. Kuch nahi bola hai, which working capital? Gross, net, nothing. Last lecture, the sum which I took, waha at least bola tha ki net working capital. Okay? Yeah. So cash and bank balance to be maintained at 15% of the working capital. Aur kya bola hai? 25% of the purchases are for cash. So I have told you, you have to read between the lines. Other part of it says that it is 80% on credit. 80% it is a credit purchase. Okay, so kya pucha hai? Draw a forecast of working capital requirement for the factory. Okay, cool. Is the question clear to everyone? Just acknowledge it in the chat box. Question samajh mein aaya? I did not do the marking, sorry. Let me do the marking. Yeah, so this is my current asset. Current asset, and this is WIP, okay? Don't forget. Ye finished goods hai, current asset. Debtors, current asset. Creditors, liability. Current liability. Time lag means outstanding. So this is also current liability. Bank balance is current assets. ठीक है, हो गया, done. So सबसे पहले हम वो working note करेंगे. We will do the working note. Yeah, thank you students. Kishmat, what are you asking? Ma'am, 75. Oh yeah. Thanks Kishmat. हाँ. अच्छा, I thought it is 20%. Yeah. Thank you so much. So this is 75%. So let us start first with the working note. My dear, working note number one. So what are you going to calculate? The cost structure, total cost and all that. Okay? Yeah. To start, raw material. Aur kya hai? Labor. Next is what? Overheads. Okay? Kitna hai? 55%. So 55% of what? Obviously selling price. Next. 18%. 18% of what? Obviously selling price. Okay, so they haven't given, but it is understood. ठीक है ना? और क्या? Overheads 17%. Okay, so write down. Overheads is 17% of selling price. ठीक है? Yeah. And selling price is how much? Selling price is कितना था? 50 rupees. Yeah. Selling price is rupees 50. Okay, so now let us calculate. Yeah. Yeah. 50 rupees ka 55% is 27.5. Please round off mat karna, ye per unit. 27.5. Next, 50 rupees ka ₹50 का 18% 9 rupees. नेक्स्ट ₹50 का 17% 8.5. टोटल इट वी विल गेट टोटल कॉस्ट. टोटल कॉस्ट मतलब कॉस्ट प्राइस. कैन इवन कॉल इट एज कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. ऐड करो प्लस 9 प्लस 27.5 कितना हुआ 45. ओके ऐड प्रॉफिट आई विल गेट माय सेलिंग प्राइस. ऐड प्रॉफिट आई विल गेट माय सेलिंग प्राइस. ठीक है तो सेलिंग प्राइस तो वी नो 50. सो जो डिफरेंस है ₹5 दैट इज माई प्रॉफिट. वैसे भी प्रॉफिट से कोई लेना देना नहीं है इस चैप्टर में है ना. इज इट क्लियर टिल योर डन. नाउ स्टार्ट विथ दिस. मेक अ वर्किंग कैपिटल का स्टेटमेंट. ओके थैंक्स डियर. Okay, particulars column, calculation column and amount column. Okay, I hope this is enough. No, it's not enough. So I extend come up here again. So give the heading working capital estimates. Working capital estimates. Okay, so particulars, calculations and amount. Many people do calculations separately in working mode. I don't prefer that. I do it alongside when we are doing the statement. Okay. Start with obviously current assets. Okay, current assets may first is stock, or you can write inventory. एक की बात है उसमें भी फर्स्ट है रॉ मटेरियल, सेकंड है WIP. WIP का तो वी नो द ब्रेकअप रॉ मटेरियल लेबर एंड ओवरहेड्स 100% 50% 50%. ठीक है नेक्स्ट फिनिश गुड्स. Okay. And don't forget, finished goods is recorded at cost price or COP will accept you. I'll tell you why do I call the word cost of production. I will take up sums after 2-3 lectures ke baad. I'll take up sums where you will strictly understand the difference between cost of production. Okay, thoda higher level sum. Okay, next. Ye ho gaya second debtors. Debtors ke liye to you know in this sum nothing is mentioned, so in absence of information I told you it is always at selling price, so don't forget that. Next समथिंग इज या कैश इज नहीं, कैश अभी हम कैलकुलेट नहीं कर सकते, या वी कैन नॉट कैलकुलेट कैश राइट नाउ. सो जस्ट टोटल दिस, यू कैन कीप दिस रेडी फर्स्ट एंड देन यू कैन यू नो सॉल्व इट, और यू कैन सॉल्व इट साइमल्टेनियसली, आपके ऊपर है. नेक्स्ट 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 या so this will give me total of current assets. Next, current liability. Okay, current liability mein I have first, yeah, creditors. Creditors is recorded as raw material purchase price. And don't forget, you have to consider only credit purchase. Next, yeah, outstanding wages and overheads. They both have the same time lag, so I can do it directly. Anything else? No. Total it. So we will get total current liability. Total current liability. Okay, so let us start now. First, raw material. Kitna hai? Mera goods quantity multiplied with rate, right? Into number of months. So my goods is 84,000. So 84,000 into what is my raw material price? 27.5. So write down. 84,000 into 27.5 into what is the time period for raw material? 1.5. So how much you will take 1.5 ko 1.5. ठीक है ना? Yeah. Am I clear? 1.5 divided by 12. Okay. Next WIP. So 84,000 units. That's my quantity. Multiplied with the rate. So rate is 27.5. Next rate is 9 rupees. And next rate is 8.5. So right here, 8.5. Okay. Multiplied with, it is how much? 15 days. 15 days ko agar main months mein convert karu to kitna aayega? 0.5. Right na? 0.5 months. So 0.5 divided by 12, 0.5 divided by 12 into, don't forget, 100%, 50% and 50%, yeah, don't forget that. Okay, so let's do the calculation. $84,000 into 27.5 into 0.5 divided by 12. 96,250. So right here, 96,250. Into 100% करोगे तो भी सेम ही आंसर आएगा. Okay. Yeah. Next, 84,000 into 9 into 0.5 divided by 12. Into 50%. 15,750. So right here, 15,750. Next, 84,000 into how much it is? 84,000 into 8.5 divided by 12 into 50%. So it is 14,875. Take it in the outer column. Yeah. Total it plus 15,750 plus 96,250. So my answer is 1,26,875. 1,26,875. Okay. Am I clear till here? Yahan tak samajh mein aaya? Let me do for raw material also. 84,000 into 27.5 into 1.5 divided by 12. 2,88,750. 2,88,750. Okay. Is it clear till here? Just acknowledge it in the chat box. Then finish good. Same. 84,000 into. You will multiply with the COP. So how much is my COP? Cost, total cost 45. Into finished goods ka time period is how much? 1 month. So 1/12. Solve this. 84,000 into 45 into 1/12. 3,15,000. So right here. 3,15,000. Okay. Yeah, thanks students for the acknowledgement. Next, datas. So 84,000 into datas will be recorded as selling price. So what is my selling price? 50 rupees. Datas ka time period kya hai? Collection period is what? 1 month. So right here, 1 month, 1/12. Solve it. 84,000 into 50 into 1/12. The answer is 3,50,000. So right here, 3,50,000. So wow, Jyoti, very good. She's already calculated. Plus 3,15,000 plus 1,26,875 plus 2,88,750. So 10,80,625 is my total. So right here, 12,80,625. So right here, 10,80,625. Right? Now coming on to the creditors. Solve 84,000 into the raw material purchase price. Eh? So that is 27.5. And the time period for creditors is how much? 2 months. And it 75% is credit purchase. So bas utna hi consider karna. So 2/12 into 75%. So 84,000 into 27.5 into 2/12 into 75%. So my answer is 2,88,750. 2,88,750. Okay. Next, outstanding wages and overheads. Same. 84,000 into. Okay. Now see here. दोनों का टाइम पीरियड सेम है, 1 month. ओके, तो मैं साथ में ले रही हूँ. आई एम नॉट कैलकुलेटिंग इट सेपरेट, आई एम सेविंग टाइम. तो टाइम लैग इज 1 month ना, या 1 month. एंड दोनों का अमाउंट कितना होगा? 9 + 8 इज अमाउंट 17. तो 17.5. ओके, सो आई एम टेकिंग इट डायरेक्टली 17.5. टाइम लैग इज 1 month. Am I clear, students? Is the logic of 17.5 clear? Why did I multiply with 17.5? Because I am taking both together instead of taking it separately. Yeah, it will save your time. Okay, 84,000 into 17.5 into 1/12. So my answer is 1,22,500. Okay, fine. Thank you, students. Oh, Jyoti is already calculating it. Very good. 1,22,500. So 1,22,500. ठीक है? Total कर दो current liability को plus 2,88,750. So my answer is 4,11,250. So write it down. 4,11,250. Okay. So now I will get my working capital, but without what? Without cash. Cash अभी तक मेरे पास नहीं है, मुझे पता भी नहीं है कितना. ठीक है, so right here, yeah, working capital without cash. Okay, yeah, वही current assets minus current liability. So solve it. Minus this 10,80,625. Kitna hua? 6,69,375 is the answer. So right here, 6,69,375. 5. Yeah, 669375. Okay, isme what I will add my cash, and then I will get my working capital after cash. Am I clear about this? Samajh mein aa raha hai? Yeah. Okay, so add cash to this dear. Add cash, and the final answer which you get will be your net working capital. Okay, writing it here, net working capital. Okay. And how are you gonna calculate this? Yeah, listen, itna bola hai cash balance to be maintained 15% of your working capital. So now students, just remember one thing, ye jo working capital hum calculate kar rahe na, ye real nahi hai, estimated hai obviously. Theek hai na? So hum estimate kare ki jitna hamara expected working capital hoga uska 15% hum cash bank balance rakhenge. Theek hai? So 15% बोला है. So wait, 15% of what? Net working capital. Last lecture. Wait, I'll show you that sum. Last lecture में they had said cash is 15% of net working capital. Today's sum they haven't said it is net working capital, but beta it is understood ki it is net working capital because aapko pata nahi hai cash aapke paas hai nahi, to jo aapne current assets nikala total that is without cash, to jo aapka working capital aaya that is without cash. And how can working capital be without cash? Cash is an important element in the calculation or estimation of working capital. So whatever you are getting is all estimated, is all future tense. Okay, so it is by default on net working capital only. Okay, so this is 15, so this is 100, net working capital is the base, so this is 85. So cross multiply. Okay, cross multiply, you get the answer. Karo cross multiply. 669375 into 100 divided by 85. So my answer is 7,87,500. 7,87,500. Okay, and the difference is my cash. 669375. So 1,18,125 का मेरा cash होना चाहिए. Okay. 1,18,125. Is the question clear, students? Samajh mein aaya, everyone? Question is clear to everyone? Just acknowledge it in the chat box. Okay, I am gonna take